Let me hear you say hallelujah. Hallelujah. One more time. Hallelujah. The Lord is worthy of praise. Amen. The Lord is worthy of praise, for his mercy endures forever. Holy Spirit has something amazing for us today. I thank God for that. And we're just going to go right in step with what he wants to do. Amen. And if you're open to it, you'll see what God is getting ready to do in the New Ark Covenant Church. Let me say, God is getting ready to do something amazing in the New Ark Covenant Church. Who wants to pray this morning? Who wants to pray? Who wants to do an opening prayer? Julio's one. Rolando, you're second. Come on up. 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 Amen. Amen. Leo, I'm going to let you go first, then Rolando's going to go second. Ed, you want to pray? Come on up. So we got Julio, we got Rolando, we got Ed. Amen. And then we're going to enter his gates with thanksgiving and praise, and we're going to receive what God has for us, a special, special gift. And then we're going to have a word from God and dismiss and go home and say, go Eagles! Amen. We got any Kansas City fans in here? Okay, as long as we don't have none of those in here, you can stay. Amen. Julio, I'm going to ask you to open us up in prayer. Then when you finish, you're going to give it to Rolando. When Rolando finishes, he's going to give it to Brother Ed. And then we're going to go into praise and worship, okay?
Thank you, God, for waking us this morning. Thank you for giving us our houses, Lord. Thank you for our families, Lord. Thank you for you, Lord.
Yes.
And that's because we need you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Without you, what we can do. Without you, who can protect us.
Yes.
Without you, who can provide for us.
Yes.
Without you, who can do anything for us?
Oh, glory to God.
So I just say we can worship God today or tomorrow.
Yes.
And in Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for bringing us all here today, Father God. Lord, we ask that you touch us, Father God, and touch us in a mighty way, Father God, so that when we leave here, Father God, that they'll see you through us, Father God. We ask that you touch our personal lives, Father God, so that we're able to be an example or mentor to upcoming Christians that's going to be following us in this church, Father God. Dear Heavenly Father God, I ask you to strengthen our families, Father God, to strengthen our peace, Father God, because you give us a peace that surpasses all understanding, Father God. Without you, we wouldn't be nothing, Father God. What can separate us from the love of Jesus? Nothing, Father God. Oh, Father God, we ask that you touch us, Father God, with your Holy Spirit, fire, Father God. Let it rain in here, Father God, and take over this whole building, Father God. And dear Heavenly Father, we ask for healing right now and protection, Father God. And we ask that you give us that joy, that everlasting joy, Father God. And dear Heavenly Father, we pray for all these things, Father God, for you in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Dear Heavenly Father, Father God, I ask that you increase our valley faith, Father God.
Yes.
Father God, mountaintops, views are on the horizon, Father God. Lord God, I can see them, Father God, but I need my faith to be increased, Father
yes,
God. I need to... not be shaken, Father God, through this tough season, Father God. Father God, I know a lot of us are going through things, Father God, but I ask that you increase our faith, Father God, so that we can stand firm, Father God, in you and knowing that you provide all things. Father God, I just ask that this week, Father God, today, tonight, tomorrow, Father God, that You give us discernment. You give us the eyes to see, the ears to hear, Father God, to see you more, Father God. Seek ye first the kingdom, Father God, and all these other things shall be released in your life, Father God. In Jesus' name, I pray all these things right now. Amen.
Come on, you guys. Come on, everybody. Come up to the altar and let's praise the Lord. Amen. Don't be shy. Give glory to God. Amen.
Let me hear you make some Holy Ghost crazy noise right now. Let me hear. Come on, Zion, clap those hands with me. Come on, come on, all God's people. Come on, Mike. Like this, come on. Here we go.
The angels bow down at the thought of you. The darkness gives way to the light for you.
Come on.
The price that you pay gives us life brand new.
What's his name?
Hosanna forever, we worship you. Hosanna forever, we worship you.
Say it again.
what I have sown. This is my season for grace, for favor. This is my season to reap what I have sown. Y'all listen at this. See, I haven't been perfect, but I sure been faithful. See, God's got a purpose, yes, and I know he's able. I've got to see in the ground that he's blessing, no more stressing. I've got to see in the ground, now I'm knowing and it's showing. My season for grace, for favor. It only works when we all do it.
This is my season.
To do what?
To reap what I have sown.
Come on, you say, this is my season
for grace.
For what else?
For favor.
This is my season
to reap what I have sown.
Listen, everything is working together for my good. Say it, church. Everything is working. Don't feel good, but it's working
for my good.
Say it again, y'all. Everything is working. Say this tonight, real simple, say, it's good,
it's good,
it's good,
it's good,
it's good. Say, it's working for my good, it's good, say it's good, say it's good, say it's working. For grace, for... I need somebody to prophesy with your body language. Just say, what you say? God is leaning in my direction. Don't prophesy. I said he's leaning. In whose direction?
In my direction.
Come on, you waiting on me to say it. You gotta say it. Say it.
He's leaning
in my direction.
In my direction.
Cause this is my season
for grace,
for favor. This is my season. Come on, y'all.
To reap what I have sown.
Will you raise your hand and say, I've got a seed in the ground. Come on, open your mouth and say, I've got a seed in the ground.
Amen. Joshua chapter 1, beginning with verse 5. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their ancestors to give them. Father, I'm blessed to be able to stand before your people to preach this powerful word that you have for them. I'm already blessed. So let him who has an ear, let them hear. And not only be hearers of your word, but doers also. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. How many times people have made promises and could not or did not keep them? People with good intentions have made promises and could not keep them. They may have made promises to a bank to pay the money back on time and not miss a payment, but they break their promise when they don't pay on time and they miss a payment. And then you have those who have married and made promises to the person they were supposed to be in love with and did not keep their promises. And then we have those who fall in love with God, they fall in love with the Lord, and make promises only to renege on those promises. Promises, promises, promises. The message this afternoon is simple and straightforward. Although mankind will renege on promises, our God will never break a promise. He is a promise keeper. I didn't get enough amens on that, because amen means I agree. Hallelujah. That our God, amen. Woo! Hallelujah. Joshua chapter 1, 5 through 6, these two verses, there are three promises. The first one, no one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. The first promise God is giving us and the children of Israel, no one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. Every single day God is saying to us this afternoon, no one will be able to stand against you. Secondly, he says, I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. He said, I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Actually, the second promise has three promises. God with you, never leave you nor forsake you. A lot of people mistakenly think forsaking you means never leave you. And the third promise is the inheritance. The title of this morning's message is Promises, Promises, Promises. Let me hear you say that with me. Promises, promises, promises. I started looking at this message with the word study of two words. Two words. That's how I began this Bible study. My own personal devotion. Strong and courageous. Those were the two words that I observed, because when you study your Bible, you should make observation, interpret what you see, and then apply it to your life. These two words stuck out to me like, wow, that's powerful. Let me see what those words mean. So I'll share that with you a little later. The two very interesting words in the Hebrew language, prayerfully, Holy Spirit will let me preach that message in the near future. However, Holy Spirit redirected me from these two words to two verses, verse 5 and verse 6 of Joshua chapter 1. We begin with the first promise to Joshua and to the believers in Christ Jesus, verse 5. If you got your Bibles or if you have your phones and you're looking at your Bible, it says, no one will be able to stand against you. God promised Joshua, who took over the leadership after Moses was told he would not go into the promised land, but Joshua and Caleb would, and the Israelites that were 40 years and older, they would go into the promised land. And Joshua, when he got this promise from God, God told him that no matter who comes up against you in the process of you taking the land, I promise that they will not prevail. They will not overcome you. You will not be defeated. I hope Holy Spirit is talking to somebody right now. He says, you will be victorious. He says, I promise you this, says the Lord. He promised that they will be victorious, that nothing will be able to stand against them. Many battles took place against Joshua's army. If you read your Bibles, they had a lot of wars. They were into some serious spiritual warfare because these people didn't want these people, these foreigners, to come into their land and take it from them. And Joshua, he was told to spy out the land before they went to go take out the land. And when they spied out the land, guess what they seen? They seen giants. They seen a vast army. And they came back and said, we can take it. But some of the spies that went with Joshua and Caleb, they didn't think they could take it. They said, those are giants. And they're a vast army. They're fortified. They're equipped. We don't have nothing. We don't have weapons like they do. We left Egypt with nothing but these shoes on our feet that have last 40 years. Hallelujah. How are we going to win this fight? And sometimes when you don't have the resources that you think you should have, you forget that you got the resource in God, and you forget that, and you go into battle thinking that I don't have enough. But God has promised you this afternoon that whatever comes up against you, you will be able to stand. Things are coming up against you, and God is reminding you this afternoon, stand. Stand, stand. Remember what I told you. This is a promise. This is nothing I said, maybe. This is a promise that I have given my people. If God promised it to you, trust me, he will keep his promise. Many battles took place against Joshua's army, but they always moved forward as long as they put their trust in God. That's why I love when we sing that song, moving forward, not turning back. I'm moving ahead. I'm here to declare to you, my past is over in you. All things are made new. Surrender my life to Christ. I'm moving forward. I'm not going back. I can stand. Nothing that comes against me will prevail. That's what my God promised me. Oh, I go through some stuff, but I'm reminded, if God be for me, well, you're going to have your battles. You're going to have these battles right up here in your mind, too. You're going to be thinking that you can't do it. But I just remember Luther Julio said, we can't do nothing without you, God. Stop looking at little Julio saying, oh, he's so cute. See Holy Spirit talking through him. These young boys, Joshua and Caleb, said, we can take it. But see, old religious people sometimes say, well, maybe we shouldn't be so bold. Maybe we shouldn't be so courageous to slow down. The devil is a liar. God kept all the promises with Moses and Joshua and the children of Israel. However, they had to be strong and courageous. You could say his promise to Joshua was conditional. He said, if you be strong and courageous, you'll be able to stand up against anybody that come against you. And just as God kept his promises with men and women of old, he will keep his promises with us. But we have to be strong and courageous and take our stand against the devil's attacks. He's coming. You know you're hearing this message. He's coming. But know that you can stand. I don't care what he brings your way. Know that you're going to be able to stand. Oh, I'm glad I'm getting some amens. See, when we trust in the promises of God, no one will be able to stand against us. If God be for us, who can be against us? God told Joshua, no one. He didn't say, man, a few may come up against you, but he said, not one will come up against you. You got to believe that with all your heart and all your soul. You can't just say amen. You got to walk in your amen. When you say, I agree, you know. When your boys, I'm using this terminology because I can relate to it a little better. Say, we're going to go take care of business. And we're going to come back strong. When you say, okay, you agree. You walk with confidence. You just don't say, yeah, I agree, and don't go. You got to go. And when God tells you, I'm going to go with you, I'm going to go before you, you got to say, let's go. I'm going with you, God, because we're going to come back victorious. We will not be defeated. The devil will attack. My God said we can stand up against those attacks, but we got to trust in the promises of God, and we got to be strong and courageous. I'm going to hit on a couple of those words, what courageous mean. You're going to be astonished when you hear what the Hebrew word courageous really, really means. See, we have the English courageous, and I think we fall a little short of the word essentially in this particular context. God told Joshua, no one will be able to stand against him all the days of his life. I'm 64 now. And God is telling me, if you live to be 94, no one will be able to prevail against you. No one. You got to receive that for yourself. You got to know that God is a promise keeper, and he would not say it if it were not true. Do y'all believe that? As long as we are on this earth, God is saying this afternoon to the believers in Christ Jesus, all the days of your lives, no one, no demon, no principalities, nor famine, none of the attacks of the adversary will be able to stand against you. No demon, no principalities, meaning all kind of demons from different regions come up against you. No famine. You will be fed not only by my word, but I'll feed you physically. No attacks from the adversary will overcome you. Don't leave here doubting that. Let him who has an ear, let him hear. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman. You got to work it. Rightly dividing the word of truth. Practice what you preach. I practice what I preach. I practice what I preach. I know no weapon formed against me shall prosper. The devil will attack this church. And he's attacking this church. But I don't worry about that. Because nothing that comes up against this church will prosper. It will not prevail. God knows our hearts. He knows our intentions. All the days of your life, he says. As long as you're on this earth, you don't have to worry about it. Ephesians 6:10 says, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. In his mighty power. A power that no human being or no other God has. A power that will destroy all the powers that come up against you. The governmental powers. The scientific powers, the other gods are no match for our God. No match for our God. No match for our God. Ephesians 6:13 says, therefore, put on the full armor of God so that you may be able to stand your ground. You see, when he was talking, Paul was talking, he was talking from a military aspect. And when the soldiers would fight, they would stand their ground. They weren't moving back. Moving forward. Moving forward. No turning back. No turning back. Though none go with me, still I will follow. No turning back. No turning back. And he took this stand. See, when a boxer takes a stand, he's going to stand in front of his opponent. And he's gonna take a stand. He's gonna make sure he's stable. He's going to make sure he's firm. And we got a message about being firm and not drifting. And I'm here to tell you, my brothers and sisters, the devil's going to come and try to counter everything God's doing. But take your stand. Don't be moved. Start moving forward so he can retreat and move backwards. Joshua took his stand, said we could take it. Let's go. If God be for us, we could take it. I don't care how big they are. I don't care how big your problems are. I don't care what your situation is. Stand firm and know that you will prevail. See, when we stand our ground, nothing will be able to stand against us, but you got to stand your ground. No one will be able to stand against you, point one. Secondly, we have here three promises in one. I love that. When Holy Spirit brought that to my attention, that's just not one promise. That's three. The second promise that God made with Joshua was, I will be with you. That's a promise. Wherever you go, God says, I'm with you. And then he says, I will never leave you. So that means wherever you go, God's going to be right there with you. And I will never forsake you. We'll talk about forsaking in a minute. But God promised Joshua he would be successful because he would be with him. You're going to be successful. Why? Because God is with you. Oh, I'm praying that you're saying amen with conviction. I'm praying that you stand in your ground when you say amen. Because the devil sees all of this and he hears all of this. He can't read your mind. So if you don't say amen, he look at you and say, well, maybe they don't agree. But when you say amen, or when you say, yeah, 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 Pastor, I hear you. I hear Holy Spirit. I will stand my ground. And know that when you stand your ground, Holy Spirit, the Lord is saying to you this afternoon, I'm with you. And I ain't leaving. And I ain't gonna forsake you. He says, you're going to be successful. The God who is all powerful is telling Joshua, don't worry about anything that tries to defeat you by obtaining what I have promised you. The devil comes only to do what? Steal, kill, and destroy. He said, don't worry about him. He can't steal nothing from you. He can't do nothing to you if you stand your ground and stay strong. The God who created this earth, the stars, the moon, the sky is the one who has all power in his hand, says, wherever you go, I am there. I put I am in all caps on my notes. I am that I am, says the Lord. I'm everything you need. God has promised us that wherever he sends us, his presence will never be withdrawn from us. God was always by Joshua's side. And Joshua knew since childhood and throughout his adulthood, he knew God would always be with him. God was always by Joshua's side. And Joshua knew this since childhood. When Joshua spied out the land with the many giants and an army that seemed fortified and powerful, he said that with God, we can take this foe and enter the land God promised us. He said, I'm going to give y'all that land. You sure God said he going to give us that land? It seemed like them people on the land. And they guarded it. Maybe he's talking about another land. Whatever God is telling you, you're going to take. Don't go into the battle saying, well, maybe it's something else. Maybe God don't want to do it that way. Then you ain't hear from God. When I hear from God, I know the devil going to come right behind me and try to say something different. But I'm going to stand firm. I'm going to stand firm on his word because, see, the devil attacked me earlier today when we started church, and it was only a few of us. I was like, Joshua, I ain't worried about you, devil. We could take it. I got faith. And God filled this house. The devil wants you to doubt God, but I stand on his promises. I stand on the promise that he gave us Tuesday when he said that he had us sitting in different sections of this church and say, I'm going to fill this church. This church will be filled with unbelievers. We can take this foe and enter the land promised to us. God promised this place to us. God promised this place to us before a year was even out. In January of last year, God said, y'all going to take another place. Y'all going. And we went to several places. The devil wanted us to doubt God, but we stayed steadfast. We stayed firm. We will not be moved. Can I preach to you a little bit longer? I just got a few more minutes, but I'm going to finish. And I'm going to send you on your way. And hopefully the Eagles can stand firm and not be moved. But the same applies to the believers in Christ right at this very moment. God promises us that he will be with us when Christ left this earth. He said, Jesus said this to us. He said, I don't leave you as orphans, but I will send the comfort to you who will be with you and in you, for I will be with you always. Yeah. Wherever you go, you got to be careful where you go, because Holy Spirit's right there with you. Yeah. See, you want him to be there with you when you're going through something, but when you're doing something, you don't want him to be around. You don't leave me. He said right there, I will never leave you. Yeah. When Christ says, I will not forsake you, he is telling us he will not fail us. He already said twice,
I'm always going to be with you. I'm not going to leave you. This time he's saying, I won't fail you. That's what forsake me. I will not fail you. If you have strength and courage, if you believe that, I won't fail you. As a matter of fact, Holy Spirit said, I can do all things but fail. I can't do that. But I can do everything else.
Yeah.
See, that's what I believe. My God's not going to fail me.
I remember when God said, son, you know, I was asking him, I said, well, why? Every time I go for a job, they say, no. Every time I go for a job, they say, well, we like you, but no. And we'll call you, don't call us. And I said, I got a little discouraged. I said, Lord, why am I failing? He said, no, you're not failing. It's part of the process. Stand firm. You'll get through this. Then I got the victory. Oh, yeah, because he said he'll never leave me, nor will he fail me. Our God has never failed, and therefore, if he promises not to fail us, forsake us, not to fail us, he will keep that promise and not. I don't know what y'all came to do, but I came to get a word from the Lord. Our God is a continual help. And an ever-present help in the presence of our adversary. There is no standing against those who have God on their side.
There is no standing against those who have God on their side. There is no standing, I don't care what you're going through, against those who have God on their side. God promised Joshua clear success, and the enemy will never gain an advantage over him all the days of his life. Do you feel like the enemy got an advantage over you? Then you don't believe Christ is with you. If you believe that you're not where you need to be, then you don't believe that Christ is by your side. You're a doubter. You're doubting God's word. He said, I promised you that. You think I break my promises? Clear success. God promised not to fail us. Trust in his word and do as he has. Stand strong and courageous. Courageous meaning, I'm going to give you a little bit more of that courageous word. Courageous meaning established. Prevailing. Confirmed. Maintained. And stacked. Those are the brothers that know a little bit about Guinness Stout. Y'all know where it's coming from, don't you? It's pop. Our God is not impotent. He is all powerful. And he says, if you be courageous, if you are established in my word, if you're prevailing in my
word, if you're confirming by saying amen in my word, if you maintain the meaning, you don't give up, do not go weary and well-doing for in due season, you'll reap a harvest if you don't give up. That means you have maintained. You're still here. You have not been moved. And there are more words that defines this powerful word, courageous, in the Hebrew, but I don't have enough time to go over all of those. But if you leave here with one, just leave here with one established, prevailing, another one. I'm going to take it home. I told you that this word courageous was a powerful Hebrew word. I don't know about y'all. See, that gripped me. If I was sitting where you were, I'd be like, I would have been writing those words down. So I know what I am all about. He's talking about me, and he's talking about what he will do if I. So we finish this afternoon with the third promise. The third promise is the inheritance. The inheritance is the promise of things to be inherited. There's a lot of people that read their Bible that don't even know what their inheritance is. But if your parents tell you, I did my will yesterday, and you're going to inherit some things, first thing you're going to want to know,
what's in that will? And you say, well, do you mind if I see the will? Oh, you'll see it when I die. But God said before I... See, I got a revelation just then. See, I was going to say before, God says, before I die, and Christ said, I died. Therefore, now you know what the inheritance is. All you got to do is read the document. A lot of people don't read the document. As soon as your loved one dies, first thing you're going to do is find out what your mama and your daddy told you. You ain't going to see it until I die. Then you'll know what I have given you. The disciples wanted to know a lot. But he said, this is not the time for me to tell you. But I will tell you. He said, so I no longer call you servants, but I call you friends. And not only are we friends of Jesus, but we are kin. He's our brother. To as many as receive him, to them he gave the right to become sons and daughters of God. God is my father. And that's when I pray, I say, my father, Father in heaven. I pray to a God that loves me as he loves his son, Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. See, the inheritance is the promise of things to be inherited. The inheritance is given to the children of Israel. And the children of Israel received, and they were told that in this promise would be a piece of land, and he will put it into their bosoms. And he said, everywhere your feet land, it will be yours. When they went into the promised land, they just didn't go into Jerusalem. They kept going because they said, all the land, the United States, India, all the land on the earth, because the earth and the fullness thereof is from God. And he said, you're going to take all the land, China, Alaska, Europe. You're going to take all the land, my children. And this was their inheritance. And God is telling us, everywhere you put your foot belongs to you, because Satan took it from you in the beginning, and I'm giving it back to you. That's why I love that song. I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. And he gave them the land and everywhere their feet went. The promise the Lord gave them was to reclaim the earth and everything that is in it. God gave this land to humanity in the beginning, but Adam gave it to the devil for a lie. God used the children of Israel to bring forth an heir who would reclaim the promise of eternal life and the abundant life. The heir would be Jesus Christ. We are co-heirs with Jesus. Read your Bibles. We have been promised to receive all the blessing that Christ himself has. Colossians 1:12, turn there, and I'm going to be through. Colossians 1:12. And giving joyful thanks, Paul says, to the Father who has qualified you to share in the inheritance of his holy people in the kingdom of light. He's talking to Gentiles there too. And he's saying that we share in this inheritance that Israel has. Everything that is promised to the children of Israel, God's chosen people, is promised to us. We have been grafted into the tree. Israel brought forth the Messiah, who is Christ, and we are co-heirs. And all the land and all the blessings belong to all humanity who put their trust in Jesus Christ, who is God. Promises, promises, promises. Take hold of all the promises of God. When we stand on all the promises of God, standing on the promises of Christ, my King, through eternal ages, let his praises ring. Standing on the promises of Christ, my King, standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of Christ, my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. That's what I sing. I sing it with conviction. When you take hold of all the promises of God, when we stand on all the promise of God, no one will be able to stand against us all the days of our lives. God will be with you, never leave you, never forsake you. Three promises in one on the second one. And then the third, he promises to give us everything that comes with being a co-heir of Jesus Christ. I was so blessed by that, I feel like dropping the mic. Because God is good.
Turn to the joy, my sister, in the name of Jesus. Amen. May y'all stand. Joy of the Lord is your strength.
Promises endure forever. Let us pray. Father, I thank you, Lord, for your word. I thank you, Lord, for your promises. And I know that anything that comes up against us, not one thing will prevail. I thank you for that, Lord. I thank you that you said you'll never leave us nor forsake us, and that you will be with us always. Thank you, God, that you gave us three promises in one. And then we are truly, truly co-heirs with Jesus. And everything that Christ has, we have too. Dismiss us, Lord, and let us walk in our courage, and let us be strong and stand against the devil's schemes. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you. Sometimes.